Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröger. Today I'm going to show you how to draw the letter C. I start with a simple sketch and after that I'm going to make a final vector of the C and I'm going to apply the C to a Christmas card. Create a new document, go to File and click New. So I use 340mm for the width and 210mm for the height and click Create. So I start the sketch with a calligraphic brush. So use the paintbrush tool and go to the brushes panel and create a new brush. Click on this button, New Brush, calligraphic brush. Click OK and I use size 3 point. OK. So next choose black color for the stroke and none color for fill. Oh, sorry. And set the opacity to 10%. And please open the options of the paintbrush tool, make a double click on it. And I use this position. Click OK. And now you can start with your sketch. In this tutorial, I will work with the pen tablet and choose the paintbrush tool and start with the sketch. So I will use the C for a Christmas card. So first move all a little bit to the left. And now choose the type tool. And write Christmas. So I continue with my sketch. Okay, I'm done with the sketch, and now it's time to make a vector of the C. So first, I'm going to copy the type, or cut it, edit, cut, and paste it in a new layer, create a new layer, go to edit, and click on paste in place. And please lock the sketch group. So for the vector, I use the pencil tool. So I start first with the C, and after I finish with the C, I'm going to draw this scroll work. So I use black color for stroke. And none color for fill. So please open the options of the pencil tool, make a double click, and I use the same position as the paintbrush tool. So next I'm going to fill all the shapes with black color. So select the whole group and change the fill color to black and set the stroke color to none. And now I make some corrections. So choose the direct selection tool and I start with this anchor point. Make it a little bit round. So next, I'm going to delete this point and now move this point a little bit to the left And if you wish, you can use the smooth tool. Select the shape. And use again the smooth tool. Okay, I'm done with the scene and now I'm continue with the background. So create a new layer and move the layer behind the letter and create a big rectangle. Choose the rectangle tool. Fill this rectangle with dark gray color and change the shape color to white. And you can create outline from your type. Select the type, go to type and click create outlines. So next I'm going to group the C, select all layers and open the options and click collect a new layer. You can rename this layer. So please lock this group and now I'm going to edit the scene. So the next thing what we need is some copies of the scene group. So make a first copy, drag this group down to the new layers button and rename it to stroke orange. And now change the color, orange color for stroke and none color for the fill. So zoom in and now open the stroke panel and change the stroke width to 3 points and the align stroke to inside. That's fine. Now make a second copy of the C group and rename it to white stroke. So change the color, none color for fill and white color for stroke and change the stroke width to 6 point or 5 point. So next I'm going to unite this white stroke, select the whole group. Open the Pathfinder. Before I'm going to unite it, it's very important to make outlines from the stroke. So go to Object, Path, and click on Outline Stroke. And now open the Pathfinder and click Unite. And now I'm going to make a copy of my white group. And now change the first white group. Change the white color to gray color. And move this gray shape a little bit to the left and down. And now we need inside this gray stroke, we need a clipping mask. So for the clipping mask, I use this basic group of my white stroke or white fill. So select the whole group and unite this group and make a compound path of this group. Go to Object, Compound Path, and click Make. And now copy this, select the layer and go to Edit, click Copy, and paste it into this gray stroke layer. Go to Edit and click Paste in Place. So it's very important to move this paste layer on top. And now I'm going to create a clipping mask to hide this gray. And it goes like this. Deselect all, go to Select and click Deselect. And now select the group layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So that's fine. And next I'm going to add some lines inside the C. So next I'm going to draw inside the C group. So select the group and now choose line segment tool and draw a line like this. So hold shift for a perfect horizontal line. And now apply a gray color. So use the same color at this stroke. And now I'm going to apply a clipping mask inside the C. So please make a copy of the C. Drag this down to the new layers button. And now move this copy on top. Now deselect all, go select and click deselect. Select the C group and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So next, I'm going to change the stroke width a little bit, set this to 2 points. Move the stroke down. And now I'm going to apply an effect to this stroke. Select the stroke, go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and choose Transform. So enable the preview and we need to start with 60 copies and use the move vertical. So that's fine. Click OK. So I'm going to move this line a little bit down. And if you wish, you can change the stroke width a little bit. So 1 point or hold down Control key and click on this small arrow. Change the stroke width in very small steps. So please open again this effect. So open the appearance panel and click on transform and change move little. Oh, enable the preview, sorry. And we need more copies, 80 copies. So that's fine. So next I'm going to change the orange color to gold. So select the whole group and convert this group to outlines. Go to Object, Path, and click Create Outline Stroke. Oh, sorry. I have to change the corners to round join. So, and now go to Object, Path, and click Outline Stroke and unite all strokes. Open the Pathfinder and click on Unite. Now open swatches and choose gradients and metals. So you can try different colors. I try this gold color, but not for stroke, for the fill. So that's fine. Okay, I'm done with the sea and now I'd like to apply a shadow layer. So first I'm going to move the Christmas a little bit. So that's fine. So unite this group and we need the C, only this compound pass. So make a copy of this compound pass and make a copy of the Christmas group. And now move a copy of the C compound pass into your Christmas group. And make a compound pass of the whole Christmas group. So the Christmas group is this. Go to Object, Compound Pass and click Make. So first move this compound pass a little bit to the right, three times and three times down. And we need a copy of this compound pass. And move the copy back two times above, up. And two times left. And now select both compound paths. Go to Pathfinder and click on this button, minus front. And change this compound has this new group. This is a shadow group. Change the fill color to gray. Oh, select the group. So next I'm going to make a backup of my group. And now I'm going to expand lines. So select the whole line group. And now go to Object, Expand Appearance. And again to Object and click Expand. Okay, and now open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Merge. That's it, I'm finished. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.